So warmly welcome to all of you for another day with another element. And just a recap, we started from the element one, why health and safety management system must be in place. And most importantly, how are we gonna maintain it and how that HSC system look like. And then we discuss as a third element, the managing risk. And in the fourth element, we realized how important it is to measure the performance of our health and safety management system, like monitoring and measurement. And just on Thursday, we started discussing some of the hazards, especially to start our RG2 preparation. So I hope you remember we started from noise as a hazard, then vibration, radiation, mental ill health, and few more hazards we shared with all of us. So just to understand how those hazards can create terrible consequences for our business, for our employees, even all stakeholders, even a terrible damage to our assets of our company. So, and today we have another element which is entirely relevant to our designing processes, the way we design our workstations, either we are sitting in offices or our employees are working on floor for different kind of activities. How are we gonna make sure, you know, the workstations or the kind of layout is designed in a way there wouldn't be any kind of muscle cramp, muscle pull or back pain or several kind of issues, which we are going to discuss in element six. That means it is all about muscle skeletal health. So as usual, we would see some of the learning objectives that we are going to learn about the work processes and practices that may give some work-related upper limb disorder. We call it VRULD also, and appropriate control measures. So criteria is the same. Starting from element number five up to 11, we'll be just discussing hazards, their associated risk, and control measures. And control measures mean the complete hierarchy of control. And the second learning objective of this element is how we gonna describe the hazards and the control measures, especially we should be considered when assessing risk from manual handling activities. So first is work-related upper limb disorders, and second is manual handling. And the third objective is all about load handling equipment. Could be forklift, could be several other, even the some kind of hand trolleys we have on floor. So the requirements for lifting operations, that would also be discussed. So two words, hazards and their controls, same like other elements. So let's start with the